until unless we complete the theory of circuit analysis, we'll be not be able to do some good questions which are, you know, little bit slightly more involved, because the involved question in circuit analysis will have everything tested, not just equivalent resistance. Fine. So let us try to learn the complete theory for circuit analysis, then we will, you know, take up few good questions. Okay, write down EMF. What is EMF? Electromotive force. Okay, it is electromotive force that a battery can generate which drives the current. Are you getting it? Fine. Now if battery has zero resistance, you know, battery can also have a resistance. Current is flowing through the battery as well. Right? All the time we are assuming that battery has no resistance. But that need not be true. Battery has its own resistance. Okay? So because of that, the potential difference across the two points in the battery is less than the EMF of the battery. Okay? EMF is the maximum amount of electromotive force, or sorry, maximum amount of potential difference that can be there between the across the two points of the battery. Fine? But if internal resistance is there, that potential difference across the two points will drop. Okay? And how much it will drop? Let us see that. Suppose you have a battery with EMF E and internal resistance R. Like this. Okay, you have this point number 1 and point number 2. And this dotted line means that everything is inside one unit. So you have inside this EMF and resistance. Just in a circuit you are showing that these are the two different things. But actually, it is one battery itself. Fine? Just for the analysis sake, we are separating internal resistance from the EMF. Is this thing clear? Okay. Now suppose current is flowing as I. This can be a part of a bigger circuit, but I am ignoring that. Directly current I am giving here. So this is I. Can you find out potential difference between 1 and 2? Right through this. Take a point here, point number 3. Now analyze this. We have done similar thing in capacitor. We used to take points and then V1 minus V2 and things like that. We need to find V1 minus V2. How much is it?
Not there. Potential difference between these two is current here multiplied by equivalent resistance between these two. There is the same potential difference across this ratio as well as that. So this potential difference divided by R3, this current, this
minus V2?
IR.
IR or minus IR?
Minus IR.
Because potential drops.
Yes.
And what is V1 minus V3?
E.
Okay? So when you add it, you will get V1 minus V2 equals to E minus IR. See, this is positive terminal of a battery. So this side will have more potential than that side. So potential will increase when you go from negative to positive potential. Any doubt on this? Any further? Okay. So now we have learned how to deal with single battery which has an internal resistance. Now we are going to deal with What if multiple batteries are there which are connected in series or parallel? What is the equivalent EMF and what is the equivalent internal resistance in both cases? Any doubt on this? Nothing? Fine. So let us proceed.
What's the EMF of?
This is the potential difference across the battery, which you will experience in the circuit. Now the interesting part is this potential difference across the battery depends on what is the current. If more current is drawn, potential difference decreases. Write down. Cells in series. How you connect cells in series? Have you ever connected cells in series in real life?
Yeah, yes,
the
battery is like
zombies,
toys and all,
we put so many. Are you still playing with toys? So in toys or remote control, you have, suppose you have to use two batteries. So you put batteries in series. Okay? One after the other, when you put, they are in series. Okay? See, my remote has parallel connection.
Sir, somebody wants
you never know whether it is series or parallel because internally how they are connected, you don't know. Okay? So you have a battery of EMF E1, okay? And internal resistance R1. Then you have another battery E2 and internal resistance R2. Fine? So you need to find out, can I replace this thing with a single battery with a single internal resistance. Let us say this is E and R. What is the value of E and what is the value of R? Assume that current I is flowing here, so here also current I should flow, isn't it? Right? So now solve it. First find the relation between that and this. The one thing which you should notice here is that these two points A and B, they are same. You can assume a third point here as C. Okay, should I do it? No, what is E equivalent?
E2 plus E1
and equivalent resistance?
R2 plus R1.
Let us see. Okay, shh. Are you guys stop talking? VC minus VP is what? E2 minus IR2. And what is VA minus VC? E1 minus IR1. When you add it up, you will get VA minus VB equals to E1 plus E2 minus I times R1 plus R2. Now VA minus VB can also be written as from that circuit. E equivalent, let's E only, E minus I into R. Fine. Now I is a variable. I can be anything. Isn't it? So coefficient should be equal. So R should be equal to R1 plus R2.
Why?
See, because this I can be anything.
So how does that mean?
Sir, the current flowing through this, does it?
See, the thing is this. If AX square plus B is equal to 2x square plus 3. Can I say A is equal to 2 and B is equal to 3? I can. X can be anything. Okay? So I am equating the coefficients of variable. So R is equal to, write down, R1 plus R2 and E is equal to E1 plus E2. Okay? Fine. So how is the series connection? In series connection, the positive side of the battery should be connected to negative side of the battery. What if it is connected like this? Then what will happen? Like this. What is equivalent EMF? E1 minus E2. And R equivalent?
R1
plus R2. Resistance will be always added up. But EMF will now get subtracted. So this is not series connection. But it is like one small variation for it. Getting it? Okay, so we have found out equivalent EMF in the case of series connection. Now let us take up the parallel connection. Okay.
Sir, so if you have to create a battery which is of a greater potential using a battery with smaller potential, which method do we use? Like series or parallel? Which connection is it? Series connection or parallel?
Series only. Equivalent EMF is greater than the largest EMF, right? E1 plus E2.
And the cells we get, like the standard cells that we get from sensor, is it like the voltage power rating? Is it inclusive of the EMF of the cell?
That is EMF only. That is EMF. But when you connect it across, the potential difference across that battery will depend on what is the current that is flowing.
Okay.
E minus IR it becomes. Okay, now connect the two batteries in parallel. How you connect two batteries in parallel? Same, the way you connect the resistance. Stop talking. This is E1, this is R1, this is E2, it is R2. Isme koi doubt hai? Isme koi doubt hai? So if current is flowing I, okay, and I'm saying that this is equivalent to that. Let's say this is E and this is R. So current here will also be I only.
Yeah.
Fine? So you need to find out what is E and what is R in terms of these. First step is find the relation between this, what is happening there and what is happening here. Okay, did you find a connection between what is happening there and what is happening here?
Yeah.
What is the connection?
The potential difference between current points would be same.
Yeah, but then that is like
the current, would be
current. Here is sum of the current there. That is the relation. So this is suppose I2 and this is I1. So I will be equal to what? I1 plus I2. Okay. And if this is point A, this is point B, then this is point A and that is point B. Okay. Shall I do it? Shall I do it? Anybody got anything? You got something, right? Let us see. Now, if I use these two points above, what will I get? VA minus VB is equal to A2 minus I R2. I was just checking whether you guys. So let us say VAB is VA minus VB is VAB. Okay, so I2 will come out to be
E2
minus VAB divided by R2. So this is I2. Okay, why I am finding in terms of VAB? Because VAB is there also. Okay, so this is I2 and I1 is what? E1 minus VAB divided by R1. Any doubt on this? Anything? No doubt, absolutely no doubt. Now here, I can say that I is equal to what? E minus VAB by R. This, you have three equations. Fine. So you have found out all the currents in terms of what is given or what is common between these two. What is common between these two? VAB. And what is given? E1, E2, R1, R2. Fine. Now I will put all the values in this equation. Try to put it. See whether you get the answer now. I is equal to E minus VAB by R. This is equal to E1 minus VAB by R1 plus E2 minus VAB by R2. Okay? Stop talking. Minus VAB by R is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 minus VAB 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Now is VAB a variable or constant?
Constant.
A variable. It depends on the current. It is a variable. Right? So I can equate the coefficients of variable. So 1 by R will be equal to what? 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So the equivalent resistance will be as if they are connected in parallel. And what about equivalent EMF? You can write E by R is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2. So you will not be able to find equivalent EMF if you don't have equivalent resistance. First you find R, then substitute this R here to get E. Okay? Any doubts on this? Aten? Is this chapter going on? To store the magnetic energy, you have inductor.